Hello, so in this video I will discuss the commerce optional syllabus. This optional syllabus will remain common for UPSC IAS and UPSC IRMS because the same question paper will be given to both the examination. The marks will be counted for both as per the choice of the candidate, right? So what is the syllabus, right? What is the syllabus? If you see the syllabus, there are paper 1 and paper 2. In the paper 1, we are dividing the paper 1 into section A and section B, right? So the question paper that comes from the UPSC, in that paper also, there will be classification of the paper into section A and section B. So the section A has 4 subjects. First subject is the costing, second is the financial accounting, third is the taxation, and fourth is the auditing, right? So all these 4 subjects are there, and there are total 4 questions here. Question number 1 to question number 4. Out of these 4 questions, you have to choose minimum 2 questions and maximum 4 questions, right? So this is the examination pattern. The question number 1 is compulsory. Question number 1 is compulsory, and from question number 2, 3, 4, you have to choose minimum 1 question and maximum 2 question to be answered, right? So there are options available, right? So this is the section A. Now, in the section A, the importance of costing and financial accounting is highest, and then taxation, and finally the auditing. Now, if you ask me how much is the strength of numerical and theory, so the strength of numerical and theory is almost equal in the first portion. In fact, the theory is a bit higher many times because the question number 1 is theory only. But you know, there are type of questions which are neither completely theory nor completely numerical. So they're asking the basic concept. For example, they're asking process account related question like normal loss, abnormal loss. So in those type of question, even though they might look like theory question, but you need to give some example. So they come in the category which are like middle category between the numerical and the theory, right? So I will say almost 50-50%, 50% theory, 50% numerical. Now, section B of paper one, right? So here, financial management is most important area. And then we have the financial markets and the institutions. This will occupy 80% strength, and this will occupy 20% strength. Here again in the section B, there are question number 5 to question number 8. Right? The question number 5 is compulsory, and out of question 6, 7, 8, you need to choose minimum 1 question and maximum 2 question, right? So total out of section A and section B, you need to choose total 5 questions. That means minimum 2 question from each category and maximum 3 question from each category. Total 5 question. So suppose you choose 2 question from section A, question number 1 is compulsory, and you choose 1 more question out of 2, 3, 4, right? Then you need to choose 3 question from the section B. So question number 5 is compulsory. From 6, 7, 8, you need to choose minimum 2 questions. Each question carries 50 marks. And inside each question, there are subparts, right? For example, the question number 1, it has 10 into 5 questions, like 10 marks into 5 questions. Total 5 subparts are here. In the question number 5 also, 10 marks question and 5 questions are there, right? From question number 2 to 4 and question number 6 to 8, there are 3 subparts in each question, not 5 subparts. So there are some questions which are 15 marker, even 20 marker, right? So normal category is 10 marker, 15 marker, 20 marker, and in some cases they will even ask 25 or 30 marker, right? So there are small questions. They will be asking you variety of questions. So it will help, number 1, it will help you avoid the dependency on few concept. Like suppose you are weak in some concept, so you will not be missing, you know, high number of marks. You will be missing maximum say 10, 15, 20 marks, right? But on the other hand, it will be challenging because it will be requiring you to prepare almost every topic of the syllabus, right? So this is the syllabus of the paper 1. Now come to the paper number 2. Okay, before I go to paper number 2, some people will be asking, sir, what is the level of paper 1? So suppose I am a BCom student, so will I be at some disadvantageous position as compared to some CA student? So my answer will be no, because in BCom, whatever you prepare, only that much level is required here. For the CA student, if you are preparing till CA intermediate level, then that is okay. No need to go for the CA final level. The syllabus is maximum CA intermediate level. And also, the syllabus is not covering all the topic of CA intermediate. It is covering only selected topic. For example, in the audit, they are covering only 3-4 topic. So you are not supposed to prepare the entire CA intermediate syllabus, right? Some of you might be asking, sir, what is the book list of paper 1? So in the paper 1, whatever book you have referred in your graduation or in your CA, better you go to those books. Those books are better because you have already referred to them. Those you are aware about the questions and all. Yeah, what you can do, you can supplement those with some coaching institute material, or you can supplement that with the previous year question, right? Solved previous year question. We are providing the solved previous year question, and you can contact our team for the solved previous year question, right? Now coming to the paper number 2. In the paper 2, there are section A and section B. Again, similarly, like very, the pattern is almost same. Paper 1, paper 2, exactly same. Here also, there will be 4 plus 4, 8 questions. Now in the section A, the two areas are organization theory and organization behavior. In the section B, the two areas are human resource management and industrial relation. Now, some of you might be asking, sir, what is the weightage of each one of them? So the weightage is almost equal. Sometime OT will be having more marks than OB, and reverse will also happen in other year. Similarly, HRM IR, sometime they will be asking HRM more than IR, but you have to keep in mind that you have to prepare every topic. No topic is less important, right? So this is the syllabus. I will be making more videos. I am sharing more videos. You can check the playlist, and you should subscribe to the Telegram channel. In the Telegram channel, we are sharing the regular current affairs, and we are also offering the courses, the classroom courses, test series, and the materials, and the guidance, and the previous question solutions. Please check on the Telegram channel and on the website. Thank you, and all the best.